breaking news. It's being called a game changer, a new deal with a big name to operate a casino in Kenosha.
12 News' Christina Palladino is live at the old Greyhound track. And Christina, they will lay all the cards on the table tomorrow.
Well, yeah, this is, of course, the former Dairyland Greyhound Park behind me. Our partners at Biz Times are reporting that it'll soon be home to a new Hard Rock Cafe and Casino. We talked to a few people here in the area who say they're all for it. However, Governor Walker still needs to sign off on it. 12 News has learned of a stunning turn of events in the long-debated Kenosha Casino project. Our partners at Biz Times are reporting the Menominee Indian Tribe of Wisconsin has signed a deal with Hard Rock Cafe International to develop and manage its $800 million casino at the former Dairyland site. Editor Steve Jagler says Thursday's expected announcement is a game changer.
Putting that brand on the project changes the conversation on so many different levels.
Jagler tells 12 News the project still needs to be approved by Governor Walker. The Hard Rock Cafe business is owned by the Seminole Tribe of Florida. As 12 News has reported in the past, 7 out of 11 Indian tribes in Wisconsin support the Menominee plan, but a few do not, including the Potawatomi tribe that runs the casino in Milwaukee.
A worldwide destination is at stake now. It's not a generic casino proposal that somebody can just say, we don't need another casino. It's not just a casino, it's a Hard Rock Cafe casino.
The Potawatomi is concerned about losing visitors from Illinois. Folks like Alfred Esquera from Chicago says he'd make the 45-minute trip to check it out.
I'm like 45 minutes away. I'm from Chicago, but you know, it's worth a trip. You know, while they're going to shop, I'm going to be there in casino. It's really good.
Chris Kospiak from Greendale doesn't want Potawatomi to lose out on business, but thinks the economic boom that a Hard Rock will bring is too good to pass up.
And I think it's going to bring in now more business to the area, and it'll also bring in more revenue to the area. So I think it's really good. More jobs. So it's a positive, I think.
And the mayor of Kenosha tells us a press conference is expected to be held around noon tomorrow, where they'll officially unveil all the information about this casino. We are live in Kenosha. Christina Palladino, WISN 12 News.
All right, Christina, thanks. In August, tribal leaders showed off their plan for the casino, which would include 3,100 slot machines, a hotel, and a conference center. The governor has said all the tribes must support the plan in order for him to sign off on it. Right now, there are just 11 tribes operating casinos in 16 Wisconsin counties.